Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In various post-production scenarios, versioning of an edited master is a big requirement for most production deliverables. However, another emerging requirement is not only do your clients want the final edited masters, but they also want the graded high-resolution sources in case any changes need to be made after the fact. In this video, you'll be covering a workflow that meets these requirements. This video is not footage specific, so please use your own material to follow along. In our example, we'll be delivering the master edit in 1080 HD, as well as the graded source material, which has a 6K resolution. In order to achieve this, you are going to use the source segment connection in the edit, which will link the grade back to the 6K source clips. So starting in the conform view, you'll go through the standard process of building a conform timeline. You choose to load an AAF, XML or EDL using the contextual menu. In the file browser, navigate to your file and select it. Calling up the preview window, you'll note that the sequence is 1080p HD. You could change that upon loading, but this is the final resolution for our deliverables. In the AAF and XML import options, disable the media searching and linking tools, as you just need the structure of the edit to get started. After loading the edited sequence, you are going to create a sources sequence. Enable Save Sources to create a separate reel for the source media, and turn off limit handles, as we want the full source footage accessible to all the sequences. Click Create Sources Sequence. This places all the media segments on a single track timeline, making grading a much easier process. You also have the ability to sort the sources sequence using either Sort A or Sort C modes in order to bunch all the common sources together using source timecode, or see the segments approximating the storyline of the edit using the record timecode. Just remember to update the sources sequence with either choice, and this will not harm your conformed timeline. Now let's bring in the media. Choose to search for the media location using the file browser. By selecting any of the clips, you'll see that this media is 6K red media at 16-bit. This was already set up through the format specifics debayering menus. Select the directory containing the media and press scan. In this particular case, Flame is matching the media through the file name and source timecode in the file header. Link the sources to the sequences. Switching to the timeline view and looking at the player with a swipe to the right edge of the UI, the source sequence has all the footage linked. And this in turn is linking the same footage into the main conformed edit. So the connection is happening at the source media level. Selecting any of the source clips in the sources reel, you can call up their properties with Alt-click, and you can see the source media resolution is 6K. You also have the indication to the bottom right of the player. Now, since the edited sequence is an HD timeline, all the 6K media is resized to the 1080p HD resolution. You can see this by selecting any segment in the sequence, and the resized timeline effects is already applied. You can set the resize mode in the Flame Preferences menu before the conform, or you can select all the segments in the sequence and change the resize mode through the Mini Effects toolbar. I recommend changing the resize settings of both sequences to avoid visual confusion when moving between the sequences. Now let's create the source segment connection to link any grading to the original source material. Go to the Sources sequence and select all the video segments. Call up the contextual menu and choose to create a source segment connection. In the pop-up window, the default option is to only affect the sequence clips in the sequences reel. Since the source clips are also in the sources reel, disable this option to consider all the reels within the active reels group. Click Create, and this connects the common source segments in the sequences as well as the source clips in the reels group. This is indicated by the chain icon in all the segments. If you don't see these, then your segments do not have a source segment connection. Now, if you also select any source clip in the sources reel and look at the green timeline tab of any of these source clips, you should also see the chain icon on the segment. So the source clips are also linked to what happens in the edit in terms of their grading and VFX timeline effects. Now you can be working in any of the sequences and performing grading and VFX. So for instance, you can go into the sources sequence and select the first segment. We'll switch to the effects environment and apply the image timeline effects to the shot. So you could go about your regular activity and apply a look using the effects environment and master grade. I'll apply a grade that I did earlier, which adjusts the color and gives the shot a dreamlike effect. To apply the same grade to all these segments in the sources sequence, you'll control select all the shots in the storyboard reel and drag and drop the image timeline effects. Coming back to the timeline view, the sources sequence is graded, but the conform sequence is not. The 6K sources in the sources reel are also not graded. To apply the same grade to all the sources, regardless of the segment's location, you need to sync the source connected segments. Now you can select all the segments in the sources sequence and call up the contextual menu. Here you have the ability to sync the connected segments. However, in doing so, it won't just sync the grade. It will sync every timeline effects associated with each segment. If that's your intention, then that's fine. But if you want to sync specific timeline effects, like the grade in the image timeline effects, you use a different menu. With all the segments still selected, call up the contextual menu over the image timeline effects in the effects bar. Here, you can sync the specific timeline effects to the shared source segments. If you have any other timeline effects on the segments, like the resize for example, these will be left alone. Now ensure that you sync to all the reels in the reels group to include the sources and not just the sequences reel. Once you complete this operation, you can switch to your conform sequence, and the grade is applied to the segments in this sequence. Additionally, if you go through the source clips on the sources reel, you'll see that they also contain the grade, and all the source footage is still at 6K. You can continue performing VFX on the conformed sequence, and if you change the grade, remember to sync the specific image timeline effects to update the 6K sources as well. Once the production is complete, you would export your sequence or sequences, and you would also export the sources reel containing all the graded high-resolution 6K media to meet your client's deliverable requirements. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2019.2 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.